My biggest concern is that by using all of these clips of different broadcasts, different interviews, different documentaries, the whole beginning, the whole first half is not our footage.
Yeah.
And I don't want it to be understood as one person's footage. I want it to be understood as multiple people.
You can make that disclaimer.
Child prostitution is not new. He started choosing the better, bad options.
Were seriously wounded at their home by a tackle.
The time for the healing of the wounds has come. The moment to preach the curses that devices has come. The time to build is upon us.
This
we have at last
is South Africa.
achieved our political emancipation. We pledge ourselves to liberate all our people from the continuing bondage of poverty, deprivation, suffering, gender, and other discrimination.
The people who use them are the criminals, and those are the people that we really need to start damping.
But overwhelmingly, the children return to the streets.
Very often they come from situations where there's enormous abuse and they attempt to come here to create a life. For me, any young person whose only way out is to sell their bodies is to me an extremely sad indictment on our society.
You can die anytime. You know, some other men can come here and take you. And then you must leave a tattoo and then you leave it. And then they take you anywhere. And then go there and sleep with you and then after that that's it.
When night falls, children, girls and boys come to these places to find clients.
You know, I've been in a school that there was men and it was only a girls' school. They actually abused us. And I went to rehab for 3 months, but it didn't really help. You know, I'm still using drugs. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm still using drugs.
Do it. But if you want to survive, what you must do, you must do it or else you will die.
No one wants to help us. That's how we feel. No one really cares.
If the government wants to do something, why don't they do something now? Because before they get children, it's beginning to die of maybe the people... customer pick him up murdering. And for what?
I just don't know. I don't know which way to go anymore. You know, I'm telling you, it's more police that actually go around and pick up calls for blowjobs and stuff like that. It is.
Now, some of you may be aware of this, but I actually took my first step into political life because of South Africa.
I do any of the stuff when I was a kid.
Yeah.
Half? No. Like, he talks about going to the park at night and looking at men who are like fondling themselves and picking them up to go to the beach and have sex with one of them for like 70 rand or whatever. And like, I can't relate to it. And then he just his age comes up again and it's completely foreign. Yeah, he seems like an adult when he talks about it. And the whole book is from his perspective. Mm-hmm. So you can't really... He doesn't really seem like he's a child. He just seems...
Mm-hmm. But he never relates himself as a grown-up. He tries to act like a grown-up.
He's written very childlike, but he's still... like a grown-up, like he's not dumb.
A lot of his thoughts and actions are actions of like a grown-up person, or like we said before, things that a lot of adults couldn't even understand.
Object to this adult world and its values. The men don't cry, he claims, and since I'm nearly 13, I mustn't cry, I must be strong, I must be a man.
In the book, it's presented that 13 is, I'm a man now, but it's not. You're still a child, so that might be his last grasp at like childhood. He wants to have his parents back. But he can't admit it because he's a man, so he can't cry, he can't be sad over it, but he still wants it. Yeah.
And not even to get away with things, but just to be able to be in that higher position so nobody has to mess with him. Because
what are you gonna do? His parents dying was kind of the trigger. He became homeless. He started to have to learn the ways.
He decided to stay, and then he got kicked out of school because he didn't go back in time.
He's kind of just choosing the better bad options.
But he never actually says that he is a grown-up.
He just wants to be.
He wants to be,
yeah. He feels like he should be, but he isn't.
He doesn't say, I do that because I am a grown-up. He says, I do that because it's what grown-ups would do.
He only works with white girls, I guess because they're easier to control. Even though they have big mouths, one clap usually shuts them up if they're not on crack.
Both things, white girls never shut up?
Yeah. If they're not on crack.
It changes your whole personality, the way you act, the way you think about everything. It's really from one extreme to the other.
He hung himself.
Gerald gives Azure a shirt and it has a picture of a lion on it. Yeah. And so when Azure goes up the mountain and he has his whole imagination, real historic thing, then he comes off the mountain to find out that Gerald is dead and there's a lion.
Could it just be a metaphor for
Yeah.
And the real story is Ezra killed Gerald, but dreamt all this stuff.
There's an article written by a guy who talked to him the day before he killed himself.
Wow.
Yeah, I hadn't found this until now. I first met him in 1997 when he was a student at Rhodes University. Sorry, I've got to go. On January 18th, I called him to arrange our meeting. After leaving a message on his cell phone, I decided to send him an email proposing that we meet soon. 2 days later, I woke to shocking news that he had died by his own hand. January 19th, 2005, I called his cell phone several times just to listen to his lively voice. That's sad.
To go from that, leaving that, and not being able to maybe continue to help, and then leave, and then write about it.
Of everyone in this novel are sort of desensitized. He became desensitized to emotion. And you don't care if you kill yourself, you don't care if you die.